Tim.
It's the morning star drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star drive, you know.
Guys, how's it going? It's Wednesday, December 29th, and this is the Morningstar Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and make sure to support us on Patreon. So what is happening on this wonderful Wednesday? We've got some coronavirus updates, current news from around the world, realizing from the Tuesday morning Proverbs, and of course, Danny's Money with Daniel Baker. So how are you guys doing? It is Wednesday. It's the middle of the week. We're halfway there, so I hope you guys are really excited and happy for all the different things that God has done for you from Monday to Wednesday. Tonight, we are looking forward to our leaders preaching, so let's start the day well today with today's show. And of course, today's even more special because we had the pre-dawn service. That's the word in the pre-dawn. We go over the Tuesday, and then we have a Wednesday message tonight, so I'm super thankful and excited for this. So let's start this day well with today's show. And just want to remind everyone, keep liking and commenting. I want to hear from you guys and see how you're doing. Write your questions, request testimonies. What are we trying to do here, guys? We're trying to build the community. And those of you guys on SoundCloud too, just to let you know, SoundCloud also has like this comment feature too. You can like the podcast too. So go ahead, like the YouTube podcast. You can like it on SoundCloud and you can leave comments on both. And I will be commenting and responding on both of those sites too, all right? So everyone, let's build the community. Everyone else is doing it. They're connecting with each other much better. Why can't we do this in Providence too, all right? So, GGG, you know, this is something that's kind of quite exciting that I want to consider doing. The GGG starts, you know, the first 15 days of the year, we give glory to God, and starts January 1st. So I thought to myself, what could we actually do? And of course, this Saturday, I will not have a podcast because it's a Saturday, right? But starting from Monday, that's going to be day three of it. And I was wondering, right? Like, what could we do as a podcast? So what I want to do is open up this channel for people to give glory in any way you want. So basically, you guys will get about 20 seconds, okay? Because we don't want to be too long. We want 20 seconds where you can do something where you're singing the chorus of a song, or you can recite some poetry, or maybe some type of confession, right? Anything that you can record in audio, you can send it to me. Give me the reasons why you did it. And I definitely, you know, let's make it like, let's make it like 30 seconds so that you can introduce yourself and say, this is what I'm going to do to give glory. And you guys can go ahead and send it on your podcast. Send it to my email and you're going to see, where would you send it? Well, I'll put my email down there for giving glory to God, right? The GGG giving glory. You know what? Send it to my Kakao or my Line. That would be great too. And if you have it, we can chat about it, and then I'll give you my email if you really want to do this. But I think it'd be really fun. I remember last time they had something in the Philippines where they're doing something about, what were they doing? It was giving glory, but everyone was singing, and then they were, you know, forwarding it and posting it and stuff like that. And I thought that was really cool too. They asked me to do it. I was like, yeah, I should do it. And then I ended up not doing it, but I think it's one of those cool things that you can do with social media, but let's do it here on the podcast. If you guys have anything that you want to put in, go ahead, send it to me. I would love to post it onto this on the first 15 days. I'm sure we're going to have about 5, maybe 10 podcasts that'll be available for you guys to give glory. I'll put it at the beginning of each of the podcasts so that people can see, listen to others giving glory to God. So super, super excited about this, and I hope that all of us can give glory. I will give glory too. I will, right? So, you know, there's a funny question someone asked me. Someone asked me a funny question. They're like going, hey, where's your home church? And I had to think about it for a long time. Because what does home church, like, I understand people who are living in the same place all the time, there's a home church for them. But for me, as I travel so much, it's like my home church is wherever I'm at. But then again, that's not a home church, right? A home church is like, that is your place where you base yourself. But I'm like, wow, I've never been anywhere long enough to call something my home church. Like, I was evangelized in LA. So I could say Bethel Church is my home church, which no longer exists. But no, it turned into the Holy Son Loves Church. So that's where I was before. That's where I was evangelized. I was there for 5 years. And that's the longest. The longest time I've ever been in church is 5 years. And that was both Bethel Church was 4.5 years. And the Lord's Church, when we first started, that was 5 years. So those two churches are the longest I've ever been in a single church before. So I don't know if I have a home church. Like, even now, I listen to three different services. I listen to, like, the LA service or the New York service because, you know, I was a head leader there too. I love listening to the services over there. And I also listen to, like, the Lord's Church, right? So I'm just like, okay, so, you know, what's my home church? Honestly, guys, I have no idea. I think I need to find one. So I need to settle down in one country, and I think that might be a little bit easier for me to finally get a home church at that point. Today, I'm getting a haircut. You know, it's going to be my last haircut before the new year, so I'm super excited about this. I'm not sure why I'm excited about it, but, you know, I'm happy about it. But I'm always nervous with haircuts. Don't you guys get nervous with haircuts? Because, like, your hair is such an important part, and you know, when you have your hairdresser or stylist, that's the one that you go to all the time because they know your head the best. So I'm just kind of like, wow, you know, I got to find a new hairdresser over here when I just found one in LA. And then I left 3 weeks later, and then now I'm getting another haircut over here, and I'm a little bit nervous because, you know, especially for guys, we cut it a lot shorter, they can make mistakes, or it doesn't look very good, and you're like, ugh, you can't stand it. But either way, really happy about this. Guys, only it's the 29th, if you think about that. We're only 2 days away, right, from the new year, so you know, it's an exciting time that we should spend just having conversations, like really good conversations with the Holy Trinity more than anything else. So I didn't have a dream last night. Do you guys have any dreams? I would love to hear your dreams too. You know, put in the comments too, you know, what kind of dreams that you've been getting lately. Also would love to hear them too. And of course, tomorrow is on Espresso with Sky will be our last video of 2021. It'll be a New Year's message, and I'm taking you guys on a tour around my house area where they have this great lake, this lake that is just all lit up. So that's kind of cool over there too. And of course, this week's Sunday edition is me. Yes, everything's about me this week, guys. It's all about me, right? So this Sunday edition is my interview. So make sure to catch the interview. It's going to be this week and next week. Next week, I'm going to do a kind of like the first message or the first Sunday edition. I'm going to give you a cool testimony, probably my favorite testimony ever between me and Sunstream. So that will be a really cool one that you guys can watch also. All right, so let's get into the member music. We'll start with the featured artist of the day. And today's featured artist is going to be Jay Root from the Paper Music Associates in Korea. He is a second gen, great artist. I hope to meet him next time I'm in Korea. This is Jay Root, and this song is one of my favorites. It's called Blaze. It's about your love being ablaze, right? Next, we have the Rapture Collective from Australia with All My Thanks and Love. And then we'll end things off with Mariah Henry from America with Lost Ones. All right, guys? So this really, really ends this year well. We only got 2 days left, and let's make sure we put in prayers for all these member artists from around the world.
내게 막혀 널 붙잡아줄 거니까 하루 종일 너의 꿈을 꾸게 될 거야 너의 아름다움 지켜줄 거야 just for you 변하지 않는 건 어때 상상이란 말은 절대 믿지 마 They will never know 네가 날 알아준 걸로 충분해 넌 바람 위에 날 빛으로 세우리 도시에 영원한 사랑 할 거야 with you forevermore you forevermore with you forevermore My love is
The Bible no longer a mystery Saving lives, taking action What a wonderful destiny Working tirelessly and we can become heavenly All I ever wanted for you is to see We can become one with the Trinity A condition was set by His highest Confess and pray, create a new mindset If you follow until the end, I promise you You will surely realize God's divineness
He's divine, y'all Alpha and Omega, he's divine. Yeah. So let's reflect on the past. You gotta look deeply at the things God has done. Salvation at the highest has been granted. That's a blessing of blessings, the Lord's mandate. Spring water that heals faster than a band-aid. COVID safe, cause his eyes was on us like a magnet. Got the seal on our foreheads, yet they can't do nothing. The devil and his gang have been disbanded.
So I praise my praise to you. So I lift my hands up high Even in my weakness Even in my struggles I'll always give my thanks and love All my thanks and love
Got so many bars that I never lose signal Keeping it lit like a candlelight vigil Lamp it to my feet and a lighter to my palm God's word is my perspective, the righteous collective Filtering pollution, being mentally selective Guarding the heart, it's a protective Do it in a new way, in spirit of physicality Do it in a new way, take your higher razor level Giving God glory, God's love is the story So rich in His love, feeling like a rich miser Love is exploding like a geyser Love so contagious, spread across the world like Pfizer Antidote for the nation
Reflect on the past, you gotta look deeply at the things God has done Salvation at the highest has been granted That's a blessing of blessings, the Lord's mandate Spring water that heals faster than a band-aid COVID safe, cause his eyes was on us like a magnet Got the seal on our foreheads, yet they can't do nothing The devil and his gang have been disbanded
So I praise my praise to you So I lift my hands up high Even in my weakness, even in my struggles I'll always give my thanks and love All my thanks and love
Okay, okay
Thank you.
I was a lost one. I found the right one. I found the right one. Yeah, we're looking for the lost ones. I was a lost one. I found the right one. I found the right one. We stay looking for someone to hold. When the right one's standing at your door, open up your heart and say, I believe in what you say, and I promise you will gain much more. Yeah, we're looking for the lost ones. I was a lost one. I found the right one. I found the right one. Yeah, we're looking for the lost ones. I was a lost one. I found the right one. I found the right one. 10 years of struggle, 10 years of pain, but I finally get to see you no more. Just calling your name. Want to wonder who? Just open up your eyes. He's waiting for you too. He's not a man in disguise. And the hardest cross to bear, but your heart's not what I wear. To think this effort and this love could overcome the dirty stairs, and it's all because of you. Yeah, it's all because of you. Said it's all because of you. Yeah, I need you. Right one standing at your door. Open up your heart and say, I believe in what you say, and I promise you will gain much more. Yeah, we're looking for the lost ones. I was a lost one. I found the right one. I found the right one. Yeah, we're looking for the lost ones. I was a lost one. I found the right one. I found the right one.
And that was Mariah Henry from America with Lost Ones. Before that, Rapture Collective from Australia with All My Thanks and Love. And of course, J Root from PMA in Korea with Blaze. All right, guys, let's get into some news going on around the world. And of course, three reasons why we listen to the news. Number one, what is the condition of the world? Number two, what is God doing in the world? And last but not least, we hear and some terrible and saddening stories. And these are the things that we can comfort God's heart in. Okay, so let's get into start off with the coronavirus updates for today. Big jump in cases. We have 282.2 million cases globally since the beginning of the pandemic, over 5.42 million deaths, and we are at a 1.92% mortality rate. Top five countries going by daily death rates. This is quite shocking, guys. So Russia's on top, 937 deaths in a single day with 23,000 cases. Now the U.S., look at this. So they have 823 deaths, right? So they're second. However, they have 229,000 cases in a day, which means what? Which means this Omicron, even though it's a dominant variant, it is not as deadly as we thought it was, right? We're having more deaths from heart disease and cancer on a daily basis than the coronavirus. And this Omicron, which I think is kind of a good sign. It means like it's kind of like weakening and it's turning into like a common cold. So I'm hoping that it continues on this direction more than anything else. Hungary. In third with 436 deaths at 7,900 cases in a single day. India, 293 deaths with 6,300 cases. And then France rounds the top five with 256 deaths and 30,000 cases. Over here in North America, of course, the U.S. is on top. Canada in second with 38 deaths at 21,000 cases. And then Mexico, 18 deaths at 803 cases. So good job for Mexico over there. Top three news going around the world. We're going to start off with the U.S. and the CDC, the Centers for Disease Control. And the U.S. has halved isolation time for asymptomatic infection. So the U.S. has halved the recommended isolation time for people with asymptomatic COVID infections from 10 to 5 days. The CDC said that this must be followed by 5 days of wearing a mask around others. hours. So while the new recommendations are not mandatory, they're closely followed by many businesses and policymakers across the U.S., and it comes as a surge in COVID cases causes travel chaos around the country. Now, here's the thing, guys. This is the U.S., the CDC, Centers for Disease Control. So if you think about this, this is not even mandatory. Asymptomatic infections, you don't have any symptoms, right? 5 days of wearing a mask around others, and that's it. And it's not mandatory. It's not mandatory. So you kind of get an idea of where this COVID virus is going and that it's getting weaker and weaker. So that's a good thing. So President Joe Biden has pledged to deal with the shortage of tests as Omicron threatens to overwhelm hospitals. And honestly, so far, when you look at a lot of the hospitals, they are not being overwhelmed. A lot of the hospitals are at like 10 to 15%, only 10 to 15% being used in like major cities like California. So it's not yet. So we're hoping that it doesn't get to that point. And the CDC has said the change is motivated by science, demonstrating that most transmission happens early in the course of illness. And it has also updated recommendations for people exposed to COVID who are either unvaccinated or yet to get a booster jab. For these groups, the CDC said it now recommends quarantine for 5 days, followed by strict mask use for an additional 5 days after exposure. And people who have received their booster shot do not need to quarantine following exposure, but should wear a mask for 10 days after the exposure. Right? And this is from the CDC. Omicron is now the dominant strain in the U.S., which has recorded more than 200,000 daily COVID infections in the last 2 days. And President Biden has warned that hospitals could be overrun, but that people do not need to panic as the country is better equipped to deal with the latest COVID surge. And he also said that new steps will include improving at-home test manufacturing and making it easier to use Google to locate nearby test centers. Now, different states and local authorities in the U.S. are introducing new measures in a bid to combat rising cases, right? Remember, deaths are down a lot, and that's why the mortality rate around the world is going down. So new vaccine requirements have come into force in New York City, including a vaccine mandate for private sector workers in the city. Let's go into second news going around the world. We're going to go to India. This is really interesting. India blocks foreign funding for Mother Teresa charity, right? So India's government has refused to renew the foreign funding license for a charity founded by Mother Teresa. The Missionaries of Charity has thousands of nuns supervising projects like homes for abandoned children, schools, clinics, and hospices. On Christmas Day, India's Home Ministry announced it had not renewed the registration due to adverse inputs. So Hindu hardliners have long accused the charity of using its programs to convert people to Christianity. The charity has denied these allegations, and in a statement on Monday, it confirmed that its renewal application has been denied and that it would not operate any foreign funding accounts until the matter is resolved. Earlier, the chief minister of West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee, drew criticism after tweeting that the government had frozen the charity's bank accounts. But the government and the country have both since denied the accounts were frozen. The Kolkata-based charity was founded in 1950 by Mother Teresa. Those of you who don't know, Roman Catholic nun who moved to India from her native Macedonia. And it's one of the world's best-known Catholic charities. And Mother Teresa was awarded a Nobel Peace Prize in 1979 for her humanitarian work. And she was declared a saint by Pope Francis in 2016, 19 years after her death. Now, the government of President Modi of India has sought to squeeze foreign funding for charities and other NGOs based in India. And last year, restrictions led to the freezing of bank accounts belonging to Greenpeace and Amnesty International. There have also been several attacks on religious minorities across India. And according to the Evangelical Fellowship of India, attacks have been prominent in the southern state of Karnataka, with nearly 40 reports of threats or violence. Now, Hindu vigilante groups disrupted Christmas celebrations in parts of the country this year, protesting outside religious gatherings and vandalizing a church in northern India. The majority of India's population are Hindu, but there are around 24 million Christians in the country, around 2% of the population, and it's home to the second largest Catholic community in Asia behind the Philippines. Now, authorities have sought to crack down on alleged campaigns to convert Hindus to Christianity and Islam, and several BJP-ruled states have recently passed or are considering passing laws that ban religious conversion for marriage, right? So this is happening in India. So this will be quite interesting to see what God does over there if any of these things actually pass. Last but not least, we're going to go into France. France tightens restrictions amid Omicron surge, and France has announced tighter COVID restrictions amid concerns over the Omicron variant. From January 3rd, remote working will become compulsory for those who can, and public gatherings will be limited to 2,000 people for indoor events. The news comes as France recorded more than 100,000 new infections on Saturday, the highest number reported in the country since the pandemic began, but the Prime Minister stopped short of implementing a New Year's Eve curfew. Now, reporters were told that the pandemic felt like a film without an ending as he unveiled the new measures at a news conference following a crisis cabinet meeting. And Health Minister Olivier Véran said coronavirus infections were doubling every 2 days, warning of a mega wave of new cases. And true, it's going to be true. This is way more infectious than the Delta variant, I think 40 to 70 times more. However, the great thing is it's not very deadly, right? So the new rules also include limits on outdoor public gatherings, which will be restricted to 5,000 people, and a ban on eating and drinking on long-distance transport. So nightclubs will remain closed until further notice, and cafes and bars will be able to provide table service only. I think that's a great thing, especially maybe that's God's judgment for people not celebrating the holidays as it should be. And employees who work from home will have to do so at least 3 days a week. Mask wearing will become compulsory in city centers. Now, the government is also shortening the length of time between booster shots from 4 months after the last vaccination to 3 months. And France's planned vaccine pass, which will require proof of vaccination, not just a negative test, to enter public spaces, will come into effect from January 15th if Parliament approves a draft bill. But Mr. Castex did not introduce a full lockdown or New Year's Eve curfew, and schools will also reopen as planned on January 3rd. Now, according to the country's coronavirus dashboard, France currently has an average of more than 70,000 new daily infections, and on Monday, more than 1,600 new hospitalizations were recorded, bringing the total number of people in hospital as a result of COVID-19 to 17,000. That's according to data from France's public health authority. Now, elsewhere in Europe, additional restrictions were announced in Germany and Greece as governments seek to stem the tide of positive cases. And gatherings in Germany will be restricted in size from December 27th, and gyms, swimming pools, and nightclubs and cinemas will be closed to the public in several states, right? So the Greek government is going to require bars and restaurants to close by midnight, and tables will be limited to 6 customers, and venues will not be allowed to cater for standing customers, and if they do not comply, music will be banned in those establishments. This was reported by Reuters news agency. And in contrast, if you look at the UK, the health secretary has said no further COVID restrictions will be implemented in England before the new year. But he said people should remain cautious and celebrate outside on New Year's Eve if possible. So both England and Scotland reported record cases over Christmas. But of course, once again, record cases, but no record deaths. So that's also good news. In sporting news, top 3 things, of course, going back to the World Junior Hockey Championships. Yes, under 20, top 10 countries coming together, including professional players. Super excited. Finland. Finland beat Austria. Guess what the score was? 7-1. Russia beats Switzerland 4-2. Germany, surprisingly, Germany beats the Czech Republic in overtime 2-1. So that was quite exciting too. And last but not least, in the World Juniors, we have Sweden just crushing Slovakia 3-0. So, of course, Canada is number 1 in their pool right now so far. But there are some really, really good teams here, too. So, I'm excited about this. In NBA action, we have the Charlotte Hornets defeating the Houston Rockets 123-99. Chicago defeating the Atlanta Hawks 130-118. Trae Young with 29 points and 9 assists. The Utah Jazz defeat the San Antonio Spurs 110-104. Rudy Gobert, 16 points, 13 rebounds, and 3 blocks. The Memphis Grizzlies beat the Phoenix Suns, surprisingly, 114-113. Dallas Mavericks beat the Portland Trailblazers 132-117. Kristaps Porzingis with 34 points and 9 rebounds. And then the Brooklyn Nets defeat the LA Clippers 124-108. James Harden with 39 points, 8 rebounds, and 15 assists. Last but not least, we are looking at the NFL Monday Night Football. The Miami Dolphins versus New Orleans Saints. Both are coming in at 7-7 records before the contest. And they basically said, whoever wins this game, we'll have almost a 70% chance to make the playoffs, while the person losing will drop to 34%. And of course, it was a Miami Dolphins 7-game winning streak defeat the New Orleans Saints 20-3. So that is the end of week 16 in the NFL, which means there's only 2 more weeks left. It's a 17-game season, And we're getting to the very end, and I'm hoping that a lot of teams will be a lot more healthier. There are a lot of injuries going on, and of course, because of COVID protocol, a lot of players that are missing games. So we're gonna, you know, let's just hope that everyone is healthy and that we'll have a very, very good playoffs when it comes to the NFL. So that is your top three news in sports, top three news in the world, and of course, your coronavirus updates, which means we're gonna get into the golden time. Yes. So what is happening for today's golden time? What type of praise and worship we're gonna have? We're gonna start off with everything God has given. Yes. Think about all the things that God has given us for 2021 and all the great things that are going to happen for 2022. And then we'll have the grace of Thanksgiving, a song of Thanksgiving to, you know, we need to give thanks as much as we can. And then we'll end things off with Together with the Holy Spirit. All right. So as one body of the Morning Star Drive, let's spend this time giving praise, honor, and glory to the Holy Trinity.
The Spirit, they are open up our eyes and to give thanks with every word we speak. We all sing praise to God, the one who made and formed our souls and spirits. We all give thanks through songs of praise. He has been the warm rays of the sun, and he has been the fresh air that we breathe, the Spirit's warm embrace, and the sweet rain of grace sent down upon us. God, raise our spirits with his love. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changed into a bride, so Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there. My spirit's in your care. This stream of thanks and grace now overflows.
I thank you, Jehovah, Lord of hosts. I thank you, Mother of my spirit. I thank you, Holy Son, Lord of love. I thank you, my Lord. I thank you, Jehovah, Lord of hosts. I thank you, Mother of my spirit. I thank you, Holy Son, Lord of love. I thank you, my Lord.
Lord, you've helped us open up our eyes and to give thanks with every word we speak. We all sing praise to God, the one who made and formed our souls and spirits. We all give thanks through songs of praise.
He has been the warm rays of the sun, and he has been the fresh air that we breathe, the Spirit's warm embrace, and the sweet rain of grace sent down upon us. God, raise our spirits with his love. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changed into a bride, so Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there. My spirit's in your care. This stream of thanks and grace now overflows.
I thank you, Jehovah, Lord of hosts. I thank you, Mother of my spirit. I thank you, Holy Son, Lord of love. I thank you, my Lord. Through you, Lord, I have a brand new life. Now I can live as your beloved bride. I'll only love you, Lord, for you have taught me about the life of heaven. My spirit will rejoice and sing. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changed into a bride, so Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there. My spirit's in your care. The stream of thanks and grace now overflows. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changed into a bride, so Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there. My spirit's in your care. The stream of thanks and grace now overflows. I praise and thank you, Lord. I sing to you with love. My spirit's changed into a bride, so Lord, be glorified. For me, you're always there. My spirit's in your care. The stream of thanks and grace now
overflows. I will testify for this great history. Use my lips.
was Together with the Holy Spirit. Man, that's good memories of the Holy Spirit movements over there in the past. Before that was The Grace of Thanksgiving. That's an oldie but a goodie. And of course, Everything God Has Given. All right, guys, so it is time for our word study for today. And of course, every Wednesdays we are doing the Tuesday Proverb Review. And this is something that's really good. I think it's good because we do hear our leaders preaching in the Tuesday Proverbs, Tuesday mornings, but it's good to get other perspectives and other angles and points of view about the Proverbs that we are listening to every single day. So there's only 9 Proverbs on this day, but really, really good and deep ones as usual. So let's start with, I'm going to start with number 1 through 4. Okay, so we're going to, I like 1 through 4. It's not all, it's talking about the same theme. However, it has a really good flow. All right. So the first one, the first proverb is the number one faithful person before God is the Messiah. Then after him, it is the prophets and the central figures in the Bible, and then the people who follow him. Okay. So if you take a look at this, it's really, you know, it's almost like a, you know, obvious, like, okay, yeah, we know. We know. And of course, it's easy to say, of course, he's the number one faithful person. Of course. But much more important than just saying, oh, yeah, he's the number one. Because that's kind of just surface level. And we're just saying he's the most faithful because of his mission. Right? More than really understanding the shimjung behind what this says. So the real thing we need to ask is why? Why is he the number one faithful person before God? Why is the Messiah this, right? And of course, we were to understand the meaning of faithfulness, it's no matter how difficult, no matter how impossible it is, they will continue even if it's their own death. So when you look at the Messiah, like for instance, look at Jesus compared to the other people in the Bible, you're seeing that not only is his suffering the worst suffering, right? But if you look at the heartache too, because here he is, the very person that they've been waiting for. All the prophets and the people were the ones pointing towards Jesus, right? And the one thing that's really sad is the very person that they have sent, the one that's come to save all of mankind, was the one that was rejected, but not just rejected, was destroyed and killed. So think about this. He had to go through the most suffering, not only physically speaking, the most hated, but on top of that, can you imagine the shimjung of the Lord, of the Messiah, where it's supposed to be the time where salvation comes to the people, where he loves his people that much, and then they turn around and they beat and they kill him, right? So, you know, if you compare him to all the prophets and the central figures, then it's like, wow, you know, this guy went through more than anyone else. And he was the one that was most hoped for. He was the one not just saving a generation of people in Israel, but all of mankind, right? So, you know, his suffering was unbearable more than anything else. And when you get to number 2, it says in the book of Revelation, it says that the Messiah is a faithful person. He is called faithful and true. Also, the Bible speaks of Noah as a perfect man and a faithful person, and those who took action following him are faithful people, right? So the one thing that we have to understand here is it's both in number 1 and number 2. It talks about not just, you know, of course the number 1 is Messiah. He goes through the most, and it's also those who follow him, right? So it's God and the Messiah is number 1, and then after him is the prophets and central figures. They're number 2 as most faithful. And think about this, even though our mission might be higher as apostles, we are not going through the same thing as those prophets and central figures in the Bible. They are alone. Look at Moses. He was alone. He had to, you know, he was chased out of Egypt from his own people, right? All these, Elijah was, you know, all these entire country went against him. The king wanted to kill him. So we're not in that type of position. And then after those are the people who follow, right? The people who follow the Messiah. And, you know, when you think about, well, why are we next? Is because the Messiah is the one who's most faithful because he goes through the most suffering and the most pain, which means that we who are following are going to be next. We're going to go through a similar level, not the same as extreme it is, but it's going to be the people who took action following him, right? That's what number two says. Those who took action following him are faithful people. So number three says, what is faithfulness? Is sincere dedication that rises from your shimjung, your deep heart, right? And when you think about that, that is the only way that you could remain in this history. Yes, sometimes we don't feel like it. Yes, sometimes we don't want to do certain things. But we have sincere dedication deep in our shimjung. Why? Because why would you stay if you didn't? You know, why would you continue? So you might think to yourself, it's like, oh, I haven't really done much, this, and this. But if you think about it, just remaining in this difficult history where people don't like you, people don't like Providence, people don't like Sun Sim, your parents and all these other people are against you, or they're even secretly in their hearts don't like it, we stay. Why? Because we have faithfulness. It's sincere dedication deep in our hearts, right? That rises from our shimjung. Yes, sometimes we may not take action. Yes, sometimes we may not be our best in faith. But we have that faithfulness because we're still here. Without that, without faithfulness, who would stay, honestly? No one, right? And that leads us to number four, is the Messiah is the most faithful person, faithful subject before God, the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Son. Why? So let's get into the nitty gritty. Because he takes action united with the Trinity in the best possible way. The rest of the followers look at him and act in his footsteps. So let's look at the deepest reasoning. Why? His action is united with the Holy Trinity. Now, is that saying that everyone else isn't? No. Prophets are taking action united with the Holy Trinity. And so are central figures. And so are we. However, because he is so united, he is taking action united with the Holy Trinity in the best possible way at the highest level. No one is more united. No one does more. Better. United with the Holy Trinity than the Messiah, right? So as we see here, we could not say that we're the ones that united where Sun seems like, oh yeah, the Holy Spirit's always 1 meter away from me, always 1 meter away from me, always, you know, it's like we have to recognize that the Holy Spirit's not like that with all of us, right? So those first four proverbs are really, really deep. I really like them. Which leads us to the next three, 5, 6, and 7. It says, before God, you are entrusted with work and are faithful according to your mission, right? So before God, right? So now we're coming in front of God. In front of God, we are entrusted with work. And when we come before God, you know, think about this is, you know, God is giving us this work. We need to be faithful according to our mission. Okay, so then number six is really awesome because it's whether you do it or not is your responsibility. However, since God has committed himself to teach you and make you, he will make you do it even by rebuking if you happen to not do it. If you still don't do it, even at the end, he will surely fulfill his will even by wielding the various lash against you. So you're like, what? Right? But two words come to my mind here. It's not rebuking. It's not lashing. What is it? It's responsibility and committed. Those are the two words that really pop out. Number one is, yeah, the work we get from God is our responsibility. It's up to us. We can do it if we want. We don't have to do it if we don't want to. It's your responsibility, right? That's part of free will. What is free will? Free will is, yes, you want to follow God, all right? So these are people who have come to this history. Right, so we're not talking about God just randomly giving work to anyone. People have come to this history. We want to run for this history, and we get work from God. Right, we get these missions. Right, we wanted it. We're the ones that I want to run for God. We wanted it. Right, we want to do something for God. So it's not like we're sitting there like God's forcing us to do missions. No, we wanted to do something, and God gave us a job. Now, interestingly, even though we asked for it and we're the ones that want to do it, we kind of still like, oh, do I still have to do this? And sometimes we don't do our responsibility. However, the second sentence is so cool, like it's so clear, is God is committed to us. That's a huge thing, guys. God is committed to you. God is committed to me. He's committed. He's there for the long haul. Right? Don't you hear about people who are scared of commitment in relationships? Why is it so scary? Because you're there until the end. You can't stop, regardless of how crazy it gets, how bad it gets. That is commitment, and God has committed himself to you. How do you know? Because even if you don't do it, he's committed to raising you, teaching you, making you. Commitment. He's committed. And that's the thing for me that's super inspiring. He'll do it until the end. Right? If you still don't do it, even at the end, he will surely fulfill his will, even by wielding the various lash against you. Right? And that for me is powerful. It's not the rebuke, it's not the lashing. Is the reason why he rebukes and lashes or whatever it is because he's committed. If you don't care, you don't say anything. Right? If a stranger bumps into you, you don't care. But if it's your lover, you care. Oh, is everything okay? What's going on? Hey, is everything fine? We have to be those that realize and understand commitment is such a powerful word. And that's why a lot of people are scared of it, but God is committed to us. We came to this history, we believed, and we said, God, I want to do this. So then God gives us a mission. And then even after we get the mission, what happens? We don't do it, right? But God is committed to you. Right? So for me, that was a really powerful word, which leads to the last, not the last one, but to the seventh proverb that says, the faithful person will work on what God has entrusted to him with all his heart, will, and life. God has chosen him from the beginning, so he will already have the talent and skills to do so. Right? So, you know, the will, we need to be faithful, right? Knowing that God is committed to us, that God truly loves us that much. We have to be faithful to our missions, right? So what does that essentially mean? God is committed to you, which means be committed to God. Be faithful. Be committed to him. You're doing the mission and work because God. And what's even cooler about this number seven is God gave you the mission because he knows you can do it. It's not some type of joke that he's trying to figure out something that will make you, you know, like trying to find something where you can't do. No, he knows you can do it. God knows you can do it. You have the skills. You have the ability, right? So since you have the skills and ability, God is giving you that mission. And some of us might say, well, God, I'm not very skilled at my mission. And the answer is some, you know, a lot of the times we learn our skills along the way. Naturally, right? So skills and abilities is not going to be like, can you, you know, do a specific task, right? A skill and ability could be more of you have the mentality to do it. So you're going to learn it no matter what. You know what I mean? Because like, for instance, even if, you know, if someone can say, well, I don't have the skills and ability to be an engineer. And the answer is no one does. You still got to learn it no matter what, right? You got to learn how to be an engineer. You can't just be an engineer because you want to be. You're not born with skills to be an engineer. You have to learn, right? So in every mission we get, no matter what, there is a learning curve. So don't be freaked out saying that, well, I'm not very good at this. Of course, no one's good at it from the very beginning, right? So I like that 5 to 7 is really good too, which leads us to 8 and 9, right? So 8, I'm going to go 8 first. If a person likes something, he will do it no matter the opposition. The faithful person is destined to carry out his mission no matter what others say, right? Because if you have to like something. And that's something that Sun Tzu said in the past. Sun Tzu said, it's not about time, it's about interest. What does that mean? It means that people have enough time. It's just a matter of what you're interested in. So from time to time, you have to make choices and decisions. And the crazy thing is, we make decisions to do something and we make decisions not to do something, right? So imagine we're doing our work. We have a choice to continue to do that work or do something else. We have a choice to do it. It's not like I don't have time. I have made the choice to do that work. So what does it mean? If a person likes something, he'll do it no matter what the opposition is. It's like this. If someone you don't like wants to meet you, what's going to happen? You're going to say, I'm busy, right? I'm busy. Busy meaning I am not going to use my choice to spend time with you. However, imagine it's like, for me, imagine it's the girl of my dreams, the girl I really, really like, and they say they want to meet me tomorrow. I will change my schedule. It's true, right? You'll change your schedule because you have interest. You like something. You change it around so that your decisions revolve around that. It's all about priorities more than anything else. When someone says, I don't have enough time, what is it essentially saying? You shouldn't be, don't be offended by this either. It means that you're not, you know, the things that I have that I'm doing is a bigger priority, which also means sometimes myself is a bigger priority than the person I want to, that wants to meet. Because I'm tired. I need some alone time. I need some time alone. And I make the choice to recuperate, recharge myself instead, right? So in the same way too, we have to realize time is about your interest. You know, that's why it says, it's, you know, what does Nassim say? It's not about time, it's about interest, right? So if a person likes something, they'll do it no matter what the opposition. And basically it says, if you like something, you become a faithful person that's destined to carry out the mission no matter what, right? That makes sense. Last but not least, number 9, there is no need to say that the talent of your mission is small or big. God has said that he entrusts greater work to those who are faithful with the work they are entrusted with. So you do not need to worry about having a small talent, okay? The size of the work isn't the issue. Why? Because God will give based on how well you do with whatever size you get. Some people say, I want to be a preacher. Why does this person get to preach? I don't. Why does this person get to lecture? Why do they get this and I don't get this? It's about what are you doing with the work you have right now? Why? It's about the value. Do you know the value of the person giving you this mission? If you realize it's the almighty, omnipotent, omniscient God that gives you this small talent, you're like, oh my goodness, God gave me this. Then no matter how big or small it is, it doesn't make a difference. You understand the value of God, what he's given you, you do that with passion and fervor because you know who gave it to you. But if you don't know the value, then what happens? Then even if the work is big, you're not going to do it because like, whatever, maybe I'll do it another time. This is one of the best ways to see it. Do they value what they have? Do they value the person who gave them gave the work? So it's not so much about the size of the work. It's more about do you understand the value of the person that's giving it to you, that God the Almighty is giving you this mission? All right. So that's the word study for today on the Tuesday Proverbs. Hope it's something that you guys were able to think even more deeply about. That means that, that's the word study for today, which means we're going to get into the song of choice for today. And of course, it is Wednesday. We're going to go to an English song. And I wanted to choose this song because I like this song. As we get to the end of the year, it's a song called Memories from Maroon 5. It works with Canon in D, which is a classical music song. And it's a great song to reflect on the year with the people and the things that have happened, right? So everyone, this is Song of Choice for today on this English Wednesday. It is Maroon 5 with Memories.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, and I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Oh, yeah. Now my heart feels like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for you, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright. Gonna raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Oh. we're here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back, memories bring back your.
And that was Maroon 5 with Memories. That's a great song to reflect on the entire year. And of course, you know, a lot of these people are singing in a very worldly way with worldly lyrics, and it's up to us to kind of change the perception, say, oh, you know, this is why I'm listening to this song, and think about it in a different way more than anything else, okay? So that means we're going to get into the last segment for today, and of course, on every single Wednesday, we have our podcast segment with Daniel Baker. He is a second gen. He's a senior in high school, going to be going to university next year. I hope everyone just enjoyed this time. He's going to talk about retirement savings. Yes, a 17-year-old is going to talk about retirement savings and how he's going to also be starting it too. So everyone, please welcome Daniel Baker with Danny's Money.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Danny's Money. Today we're going to talk about the 401k retirement account. So a 401k plan is sponsored by a company, and employees can contribute a percent of their income. Usually it's around 5% of their income, and employers can match those contributions. Now you might think, wow, this sounds like free money, which you are correct. It is free money. It is money that you put into account, and that account gets invested, of course, and your employer will say, you know, that 5%, I will match that 5%. So it's kind of like an extra bonus you get for actually being proactive and investing long term. So there is two types of 401ks, a traditional 401k and a Roth 401k. With a traditional 401k, you can contribute X amount of pre-tax dollars into your account. This means that this money will not be immediately taxed. You just put this money into the investment account. Now this means that you have a smaller tax bill needed to pay yearly. However, at the age of 59 and a half, when you choose to withdraw that money, then that money will get taxed, and a good chunk of that money that grew over time is now going to go to the government. Now, however, that the second version of a 401k is a Roth 401k. The Roth 401k is a reverse of the traditional 401k. You put in money that you already paid tax on, and the company also matches that contribution. Then your portfolio grows. At the age of 59 and a half, that's the golden age, you can take out that money tax-free. Now, if you had to choose between these two, it's more about preference, to be honest, because if you want a lower tax bill at the end of the year, you might want to invest in a 401k, a traditional 401k account. However, the one that I recommend is the one that you get the most out of your investments. You know, if you're going to invest your money, you want to get the most return. And as compounding grows and grows, you want to get the most money out of that compounding. That's why I would recommend that you get a Roth 401k. This is the best option for investors that want to have the most amount of money after they retire. When you get taxed on your investment, a good chunk of that investment or the gains you get from your investments is taxed. Like it's 10-20%. Now let's talk about the next topic. It is a Roth IRA. A Roth IRA is the same concept of the Roth 401k. An investor can invest up to $6,000 a year into a Roth IRA, and after that money compounds and it grows, you can withdraw it tax-free at the age of 59 and a half. Now, why would you invest in these 401ks and Roth IRAs? You invest these money yearly for the compounding effect. It kind of locks down your money, so you kind of don't want to you kind of don't want to, you know, jump out of the market. Because if you take your funds out of the market, in your Roth IRA or a 401k fund out of the market, then you get taxed heavily, like even more than the amount you get taxed, plus like an extra fee that you have to pay, which is astronomical. It's going to take a big chunk of the gains that you actually made. Now, you can see that if you use a Roth IRA compared to a regular investing account, if you started from the age of 19 and retired at the age of 65, and you first deposited $7,000, then every year you invested $5,000, with a 7% return, you would have, for a traditional regular account or a traditional IRA, you will have around $1.5 million in your IRA account. But if you had a Roth IRA, because you are taxed less when you withdraw, you will be able to withdraw $1.7 million, a big difference in the amount you are taxed if you use a Roth IRA. So I hope you guys now know more information about these long-term investment accounts that you can be using in the future. And I really hope that you guys open up a Roth IRA account. And I think that will be one of my first things that I do if I get a job in America. And this is going to be the first thing that I either make a Roth IRA account or Roth 401k account, so I can get that extra money into my investment accounts. I hope you guys enjoyed this podcast. This was Danny's Money. And have a nice week with the Lord. Peace out, guys. Bye-bye.
And there you have it. That is Daniel Baker over there in Korea, getting ready for university. Thank you so much for this wonderful segment on retirement savings. I hope, you know what? Not hope. I better start doing mine. And he's like 25 years ahead of me. He's 25 years ahead of me. He's going to be so much better off in the future than I am. Either way, thank you so much once again for another awesome segment of Danny's Money. Hope you guys really, really enjoyed it. Everyone, have an amazing and awesome Wednesday service tonight. I hope you guys really enjoy it. Make sure to encourage and pray for your leaders who are preaching. And then we'll see you guys again tomorrow on the Morning Star Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morning Star Drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the Morning Star Drive, you know. I'm burning with desire and the passion.